a holy one. We serve the Lord who heals every sickness. I serve the God who restores every broken marriage. I serve the Lord who comforts widows. I serve the Lord who's the husband of every single lady. I serve the Lord who restores, who is faithful, because He is holy. He is too holy. He is too great. He's amazing. Because the God that we serve, He is here this morning. And I don't know what it is that's in your heart. I don't know what you carry, but you need to lay your burdens down. And you need to tell that situation that holy is my God. Holy is the King that I serve. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Father God, we worship you. We say, worthy are you, O God. There is no other God like you. We give you praise, we give you glory even in this place. We lift up your holy name, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We ascribe all greatness unto you, O God. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for being in our midst this morning. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for dwelling in our praise and in our worship. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for all that you have done and for all that you will do, even in today's service. We give you praise. We give you glory. We adore and we exalt your holy name. We magnify you, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we have worshipped. In Jesus' mighty name we have worshipped. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We bless and we exalt your holy name. We thank you for your mighty presence even in our midst this morning. We are confident that the heavens are open. We are confident that our praise and our worship has gone up to you as a sweet-smelling savour. Father God Almighty, even as we have welcomed you into our midst, Lord God Almighty, come and do what only you alone can do. We thank you for today's service. We thank you for everyone that is here. We thank you for those that are on their way. Father God, this is a new day. And this is a new week. Come and do a new thing even in today's service in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray, Lord God Almighty, that as the word goes forth, it will go forth with power. We pray, Lord God Almighty, you will meet each and every one of us at our point of needs. Even as we are wrapping up, even the first half of this year, we pray that you will give us the word even for the second half of this year. And the provision that we need to finish strong in the mighty name of Jesus. We declare that today will be a day of salvation. It will be a day of healing. It will be a day of deliverance. It will be a day of open doors. You will shower us with your blessing. You will do what only you alone can do. That at the end of this service, all glory and all praise will be ascribed unto your holy name. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to use this opportunity to welcome everyone to the Fresh Anointing Service. How many people are happy to be in the house of the Lord this morning? How many people know that we have entered today's service and that the Lord is already in our midst this morning? We give God all the glory and we give God all the praise. We just want to welcome you. And we know that your coming out this morning will not be in vain in the mighty name of Jesus. God has something special for you and God wants to do something new in your life. And I just want to encourage you that even as you have come out this morning, I want you to be expectant. Amen. You have to be expectant. You cannot come into the presence of the Lord without an expectancy. And as the Bible says that your expectation will not be cut short, I decree in the mighty name of Jesus that your expectation this morning will not be cut short in Jesus' mighty name. Whatever desire you have brought here, the Lord will meet you at your point of need in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will shine his face upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. He will give you direction. He will give you leading in the mighty name of Jesus. So we just want to use this opportunity to welcome you. And even in that same attitude, I want everyone to rise to their feet. I want you to encourage someone on your left. I want you to encourage someone on your right. I want you to welcome them and I want you to congratulate them that they are here today. And let them know that their coming out today will not be in vain. Speak a word of encouragement even unto them this morning in Jesus' mighty name.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It's time for our congregational prayer, and this is a time where we join our faith with other members trusting in God for one thing or the other. I want you to join me right now as we thank the Lord for a member is thanking God for another year in her life. God has been faithful. If I were you, I'd begin to thank the Lord because God has been faithful. You woke up this morning, not because you are able to, but by his grace, you slept, you woke up, you can move your whole body. Begin to thank the Lord as well. A member is thanking God for life.
and soundness of mind. Father, I'm grateful that I have soundness of mind, that I'm not in the hospital. I can think, I can see. If I were you, I would rise up and thank the Lord, because to him be the glory that we have our mind intact, that we can think, we can comprehend, we can hear. Father, we thank you this morning for soundness of mind. In the same attitude, let's join our faith. A member is asking us to join her in prayer for our marriage. Let's begin to pray that this marriage will stand in the mighty name of Jesus. This marriage will stand. She's saying, pray with me that there will be no divorce. Begin to pray that this marriage will stand. There shall be oneness. There shall be unity. There shall be love. There shall be reconciliation in the mighty name of Jesus. Begin to pray for your own marriages as well. If you are single, begin to pray. This is about relationship. I want us to open up our mouth, begin to pray and join our faith with this person. I declare that this marriage will stand in the mighty name of Jesus. We come against every spirit of distraction. We come against every spirit of confusion. We come against every misunderstanding. We pray for oneness. We pray for unity. We pray for love. We pray, Lord, oh my God, there shall be understanding. There shall be communication. They shall be able to understand one another. Let's begin to pray. And another member is saying, let's join me in prayer for immigration concerning my nephew. Begin to pray. Bible says, wherever your feet shall tread upon, you shall possess. I decree, I will pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus that this person will find favor. The Bible says he will surround us with a shield. Begin to pray for with this person that they will find favor concerning their student immigration, student visa, that as they go for their interview, the Lord will favor them. They will be granted their heart desires in the mighty name of Jesus. And lastly, another member is saying, pray for Johnny mercies with me as I travel back and forth to Nigeria. Let's begin to pray that the Lord will grant her Johnny mercies in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will go before her and bring her back safely in the mighty name of Jesus. And let's begin to pray that this week will be a great week for you in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord will open doors upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. And that will find favor in the mighty name of Jesus. One thing that you are trusting the Lord for, begin to ask the Lord right now. And I believe that even as we pray together, the Lord will make it happen in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you because you have heard us. You said even before we open our mouth, oh Lord, you have heard. We thank you, Lord, oh my God, as these people have put down their petitions, it is done in the mighty name of Jesus. This marriage will stand in the mighty name of Jesus. This student visa interview, Lord, oh my God, they will be granted that favor in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, journey mercies, oh Lord. And for everyone trusting you for one thing or the other, Father, it is done. Because you say unto the righteous, it is well. And we say unto you this morning, it is well. In Jesus' name we have prayed. We can be seated. I want to encourage the person that wrote the prayer request about the marriage to please see one of the associate pastors and just for them to join you in prayers. And as you do so, the Lord will help and grant your marriage standing in the mighty name of Jesus. Without much ado, let's put our hands together to the wonderful, beautiful choir, Perfected Praise, as they come up.
Good morning, church. You all look beautiful. So it means that